Welcome back. Let's learn about FedRAMP. Let's begin with an overview. The Federal Risk and Authorization Management Program, or FedRAMP, is a federal program which standardizes federal security requirements for cloud service providers, or CSPs. Prior to FedRAMP, each federal agency had different security requirements for CSPs. This made it very difficult for CSPs because each agency had its own ATO process and there was limited to no reciprocity. Now, when I say CSP, think about the traditional cloud computing models, which are infrastructure as a service, platform as a service, and software as a service. Here's some examples. Infrastructure as a service includes AWS, Azure, and Google Cloud. Platform as a service includes AWS Lambda and Google App Engine. Software as a service includes Keepers Security Password Manager, Microsoft 365, and Zendesk. The Joint Authorization Board, or JAB, is the primary governance and decision-making body for FedRAMP. The JAB consists of the CIOs from the Department of Defense, the Department of Homeland Security, and the General Services Administration. The idea behind FedRAMP is to authorize a CSP once, and then the FedRAMP ATO package can be leveraged by other federal agencies, eliminating that need to go through the full-blown ATO process every single time. FedRAMP leverages the NIST 853 controls that we have discussed previously. Let's talk about FedRAMP's impact level baselines. The low impact baseline has 156 security controls. FedRAMP currently has two baselines for systems with low impact data. The low impact baseline we are looking at now, and a tailored low impact software as a service baseline. The low impact baseline is used for cloud systems where the loss of confidentiality, integrity, and availability would have limited adverse effect to an agency's operations, assets, or individuals. The low-impact SaaS baseline also has 156 security controls, but it provides a tailored baseline. It's meant for SaaS products that don't store personally identifiable information beyond what is generally required for logging in, such as a username, password, and email address. The authorization process is abbreviated by consolidating documentation and allowing less controls to be tested. The low-impact SaaS baseline is used for cloud systems where the loss of confidentiality, integrity, and availability would have limited adverse effect to an agency's operations, assets, or individuals. The moderate impact baseline has 323 security controls. If you recall, DFARS 7012 requires systems that contain DoD CUI to meet security requirements equivalent to the FedRAMP moderate baseline. We'll talk about FedRAMP equivalency in a future lecture. The majority of FedRAMP authorizations are at the moderate baseline. The moderate impact baseline is used for cloud systems where the loss of confidentiality, integrity, and availability would have serious adverse effect to an agency's operations, assets, or individuals. Serious adverse effects are defined as significant operational damage to agency assets, financial loss, or individual harm that is not loss of life or serious life-threatening injuries. The high impact baseline has 410 security controls. It's typically used for cloud systems supporting law enforcement, emergency services, or financial and health. FedRAMP states that the high baseline was created to protect the government's most sensitive unclassified data in cloud computing environments where the loss of confidentiality, integrity, and availability would have severe adverse effects to an agency's operations, assets, or individuals. Serious adverse effects involve protection of life and financial ruin. The FedRAMP office has done its best to standardize the security requirements for federal agencies, but agencies can still establish supplemental requirements. The DoD has established supplemental requirements for authorizing cloud computing in its Cloud Security Requirements Guide, or SRG. In this SRG, they define four impact levels, which state the level of information the cloud system is authorized to contain. Want to know something weird, though? Notice that FedRAMP Moderate is equivalent to Impact Level 2. Impact Level 2 is used to authorize DoD cloud systems that host information on public websites or non-critical mission information. And Impact Levels 4 and 5 authorize DoD cloud systems which host CUI. DFAR 7012 requires that contractor cloud systems which host CUI meet the requirements of FedRAMP Moderate, which is equivalent to DoD's Impact Level 2, which authorizes websites that host publicly available data. That's kind of weird. The DoD controls this SRG in DFAR 7012, so I'm not sure why there is a disconnect. Just know that agencies can establish additional requirements, even if a system is already FedRAMP authorized. And also, in case you were wondering, the DoD's SRG has nothing to do with NIST 800-171 or CMMC. The SRG only applies to government systems, not corporate systems belonging to a contractor. All right, let's summarize. FedRAMP is a federal program which standardizes federal security requirements for cloud service providers. The Joint Authorization Board is the primary governance and decision-making body. A cloud service provider's FedRAMP ATO is meant to be reused by multiple agencies. FedRAMP leverages the NIST 853 controls. There are four impact levels: low impact SaaS, moderate impact, and high impact. DFAR 7012 requires cloud systems that contain CUI to meet the security requirements of the FedRAMP moderate baseline. And as we discussed, demonstrating equivalency can be difficult. So the best case in most situations is to simply use a cloud system that is FedRAMP moderate authorized. That's all for this section. We'll see you in the next one.